Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for July the 24th of 2020, well, it is titled Magic NEOWISE. So what do we see here? Well, this is the telescope area, which is known as the Magic Telescopes, and that is for Major Atmospheric Gamma Imaging Cherenkov. And what those are telescopes that look for gamma rays from space. Now, one of the problems with observing gamma rays for astronomers is that they do not penetrate through the Earth's atmosphere. So gamma ray telescopes generally have to be up above the atmosphere, because our atmosphere will absorb gamma rays, which is fortunate for us down here on the surface of the Earth, in that the gamma rays are not constantly bombarding us when we go outside. However, in terms of being able to observe them, that makes things a little more difficult. So how can we observe them from the surface of the Earth when they don't make it down to the surface of the Earth? Well, these don't observe the gamma rays directly, but flashes of light that occur when the gamma rays impact the Earth's upper atmosphere. So gamma rays are just like visible light, but of a much higher energy and a much shorter wavelength. So they slam into the Earth's upper atmosphere and cause particles to shower down. And we can get the light from those that we can then see and then work backwards to learn about the gamma rays that hit in the first place. So it's kind of an indirect method to be able to see them, but it is one way that we can look at gamma rays from the surface of the Earth. Now, it's wonderful to put telescopes up in space, but of course it is more expensive and there are difficulties in terms of being able to service the telescope if something goes wrong. You have to be, how do you get back up to it, depending on where that telescope happens to be up in space. So it can be very difficult. So it's actually a lot easier to service one that, of course, is down here on the surface of the Earth. Now, also, we see here the NEOWISE comet, and that is off to the left here between a couple of the telescopes. And we've been looking at comet NEOWISE over the last couple of weeks quite often, a prominent comet now in the evening sky and identified right here, right below the Big Dipper. You can see the Big Dipper up above pointing down towards the ground, its handle pointing up and the bowl of it pointing down towards the central telescope. And kind of right below that, you can see the comet NEOWISE. And that's one way to be able to identify it, and honestly, a very helpful one, because many people are able to identify the Big Dipper in the sky. So if you can find the Big Dipper, you know in which direction to look, kind of down below the bowl, and give you a chance to see comet NEOWISE perhaps over this coming week as our last chance before it starts to head back out to the outer solar system. And as it moves away from the Earth and the sun, it will begin to dim and become harder and harder to see. So we get to see that. Now, if we also note, if you look on the other side of the telescope there, you can see a part of our Milky Way galaxy. So the star clouds and dust clouds of our Milky Way visible on the right side of the central telescope there. So not only do we get to see the telescopes, which are used to detect gamma rays from space, we get to see comet NEOWISE and our own Milky Way galaxy. So that was our picture of the day for July the 24th of 2020. It was titled Magic NEOWISE. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be from a rotating planet. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.